Dear Mr. Wright, thank you for sharing the good news from your client. Booze Supplies will gladly refund the money paid for the 12 bottles of wine that were broken instead of shipping 12 more bottles. The acceptance of the remaining 1,188 bottles of wine is appreciated. We consider the claim settled and look forward to providing you more wine and other types of alcohol in the future. Thank you for researching and sharing the UCC rules associated to the transaction. For clarification purposes, we should review additional sections of the UCC. As you noted, Booze offered to replace the wine bottles and they would have arrived by June 4th, which is 3 days after the due date of June 1st. It is a good issue to raise as it follows the UCC Section 2-508. Which allows contracts to extend beyond the contract time because the seller has a right to more time to cure defective performance in shipping. Under this provision, even where the contract period is expired and the buyer has rejected a non-conforming tender or has revoked an acceptance, the seller may substitute a conforming tender if he or she had reasonable grounds to believe that the non-conforming tender would be accepted, and if he or she seasonably notifies the buyer of the intention to substitute a conforming tender. Here, the intention to cure was offered before the due date, even though the delivery date for the replacement was after the due date. It is impossible to replace items at due dates, and it would be an unreasonable expectation. Courts frequently consider factors including contextual evidence such as course of performance, course of dealing, and usage of trade. Even if the parties have not expressly agreed to a particular scope for an inspection, contextual evidence about their behaviors, about the business environment in which they operate, help to identify what constitutes a reasonable opportunity to inspect. Here, losing a few broken bottles out of a shipment of 1,200 bottles is a common risk, and unfortunately, it happens sometimes. UCC 1-303 covers course of performance, course of dealing, and usage of trade. A course of performance is a sequence of conduct between the parties to a particular transaction that exists if the agreement of parties with respect to the transaction involves repeated occasions for performance by a party, and the other party, with knowledge of the nature of the performance and the opportunity for objection to it, accepts the performance. Here, both Liquor Lose and Booze Supplies have come up with a solution that is fair, and it helps to foster a continued business relationship. A usage of trade is any practice or method of dealing, having such regularity of observance in a place, location, or trade as to justify an expectation that it will be observed with respect to the transaction in question. Here, replacing broken bottles, giving a credit to the next purchase, or paying for the value of the broken bottles is common usage of trade in the alcohol sales industry. Buyers may reject goods that fail to conform in any respect at time of delivery or after delivery, as you noted. The so-called perfect tender rule is tempered, however, by the seller's right under certain circumstances to cure the defect. The factors to be considered would be the language of the contract, industry standards, whether the buyer acted in good faith and in commercially reasonable manner, and whether sending back only the particular goods rejected makes the goods materially less valuable to the seller. Here, the contract allowed for FOB buyers, so Booze is responsible for replacing the wine or reimbursing Liquor Lose for the bottles that were broken. Each bottle of wine is sold separately to customers of Liquor Lose. Asking for a refund for the broken bottles is a reasonable solution. Thank you for working towards a solution that is agreeable to all parties. My wish is that Booze can continue to supply Liquor Lose with high quality wines and other types of alcohol in the future. Thank you for your time.